Okay, assalamualaikum and welcome to our class. Today we are going to understand industrial internet and wireless internet in chapter 8. So this is our outline. What is internet? For the first, we are going to study about what is internet, industrial internet, wireless internet, and comparison between TCP/IP and industrial internet. So what is internet? Okay, internet is a physical layer. Internet is a physical layer connection, widely considered that the standard in modern internet communication. Okay, in the office, everything around us is connected to the internet, and it's going to be through internet. So within industrial application, the amount of process and control information and data that's going to be delivered and collected is increasing exponentially. So the demands on the existing communications methods are becoming much greater day over day. So internet's data rate or speed is actually much, much higher than a lot of the traditional field bus systems. And so it's becoming the most commonly used industrial communication protocol today, but it didn't used to be that way. So just quickly, let's go back in the in time a little bit and look at the some of the traditional industrial field buses that are used and see what they were capable of. So there is a list here of various traditional industrial communication, and I want to draw your attention to the center and this, the right-hand column. So if you can see, many of them were able to drive quite long distance. Yeah. Okay. If you can see here, many of them were able to drive the quite long distance lah here. So for example, if you look at Modbus, you can see that it's able to drive as far as 1.2 kilometer at center column, right? So if you look in the right column, it's only able to drive up to 50 meters and off. And of course, the reason for that is the data rate at which Modbus is being driven. So the data rate and cable reach for this kind of field bus are inversely proportional. So with this increase in data and speed being needed in industrial application, so these field buses don't necessarily meet all of the needs any longer. Okay. Okay, next is, so why we didn't just use internet from the beginning? So why didn't we just use internet from the beginning? So conventional internet here, as you can see here, it's interoperable. It can drive up to 100 meters, and also the data rate goes up to either 10 megabits per second or 100 megabit per second or even higher lah. So industrial internet has much greater requirements. It's need all of those three. But in addition, it needs to be able to survive the very harsh environment of the industrial application. It needs to be pretty accurate lah as well. And the traditional internet inaccuracy is a big inconvenience, and but it's not catastrophic, and it can be in industrial internet, and probably most the system must be deterministic, and traditional internet was not deterministic. Okay, traditional internet or conventional internet was not deterministic, and with the advance in today's technology, it has become that way. Okay, and the meaning of the deterministic, or we call it as determinism, is it can, for this deterministic, it can reduce maintenance costs due to a lot of cable need to be used when in traditional internet, and enable faster cycles times, faster production rate, and lower per unit, and ability to add more nodes on a single bus. Okay. Okay, next is, okay, there are some basic about industrial internet that all industrial internet protocol share. So the first one is to, is that naturally all are based on the Ethernet hardware and thus share the physical and data link layers. Also, due to the harsh environmental condition, industrial Ethernet components are designed differently from commercial ones. So it depends on the industrial Ethernet components, like industrial Ethernet environmental. So when the environment very harsh environment, so it's designed based on the that environment lah. So cables and connector, this cable and connector are built with a heavier locking mechanism and are typically shielded to protect against noise and to enhance durability. So next is, okay, for this, industrial Ethernet protocol can connect devices via two main methods, wired, there are wired Ethernet and or wireless Ethernet. So for the wired Ethernet, wired Ethernet uses the standard RJ45 cable and connector, and wired Ethernet comprises the majority of the world's industrial network install base, and due to this, it is normally referred to as simply Ethernet. Okay, so on the other hand, wireless Ethernet, or we call it as RF-based Wi-Fi, has experienced initial difficulties entering the industrial market, but as reliability and security issues are addressed, it is predicted to gain more acceptance. And we will explain in detail in the next slide about this wireless internet or Wi-Fi lah. So as you can see nowadays, all major automation companies in the world rely heavily on industrial Ethernet protocols. Nowadays, Siemens, Rockwell Automation, or apa lagi, Beckhoff, just a few of these companies lah to use this wireless internet. Okay, next is wireless internet. Okay, briefly, wireless internet is the standard wireless networking, and also known as a Wi-Fi. Wi-Fi is a family of wireless network protocol based on the IEEE 802.11 family of standard lah, which are commonly used for a local area networking of devices and internet access, allowing nearby digital devices to exchange data by radio wave. Okay, lastly is the comparison. And just explain in brief lah, the comparison between TCP/IP and industrial Ethernet. So actually there are a lot of protocols such as Ethernet, IP, Profinet, and Modbus TCP/IP and Edge lah normally, that have been used in industrial Ethernet. So, but in this section, we are going to understand the difference between TCP/IP and industrial Ethernet. So as previous study in chapter 6, you have studied in chapter 6, TCP/IP is a set of rules or protocols governing communication among all computers on the internet. So the TCP/IP stands for the Transmission Control Protocol or Internet Protocol, and TCP is responsible for data delivery once the IP address has been found. Kan? TCP is responsible for data delivery. Remember that? And once the TCP, the IP address has been found. And then IP is the part of the that obtain the address to which data is sent. So do you remember that? Okay. So that is the definition of the TCP lah actually. So why industrial Ethernet is the use of Ethernet in an industrial environment with protocol that provide determinism and real-time control. So it is a specialized form of Ethernet technology designed specifically for use in industrial setting, providing a reliable and robust network infrastructure for connecting various devices and systems. So industrial Ethernet protocols include Ethernet CAT, Ethernet. So here, okay. So as I mentioned before, actually there are a lot of protocols such as Ethernet IP and Ethernet IP. So we have Profinet and Modbus TCP/IP lah. Modbus TCP/IP, Ethernet, Profinet, and that have been used in industrial Ethernet. So from this we are going to discuss about TCP only. So in industrial Ethernet protocol, here we have Ethernet, Profinet, Modbus. Maybe we have also, nowadays we have PowerLink, Cercos, okay. And then CC-Link, IE, and also Modbus TCP/IP lah. So TCP/IP ni is a part of the of this protocol. So we discuss about TCP lah for this chapter. Okay, and here TCP/IP for network topology and performance ni, TCP/IP operates on a wide range of network topology, including local area network LANs and wide area networks WAN and the internet itself, and it operates at varying speeds depending on the network infrastructure and equipment use. So while industrial internet is used in industrial automation, industrial internet is used in industrial automation and control system. So industry network normally use ring or star topology. You have studied in previous chapter. Normally use ring or star topologies to ensure the redundancy and minimize downtime, enabling seamless connectivity even in harsh industry environment. Okay. And it is emphasized high speed communication, deterministic behavior, and low latency, faster data, and also the faster data transfer rates, and it's ensuring real-time control, monitoring, synchronization of device in industrial setting. So in this industry, you must remember that in this industrial networks normally use ring or star topology lah to ensure the redundancy and minimizing downtime, enabling seamless connectivity in harsh environment lah. Okay, next is, okay, for the summary of this, in summary, TCP IP and industrial internet differ in terms of their underlying protocols, okay? Design architecture, network topologies. So the difference between TCP IP ni, you must look at the their underlying protocol based on design, architecture, network topology. Topologies, performance, characteristic, and industrial application. So you must consider to use the protocol in industrial internet based on this consideration lah. Design architecture, network topologies, performance characteristic, and industrial application. While TCP/IP is a universal protocol for general communication and data transmission, industrial internet is tailored to meet a specialized requirement of industrial automation, offering real-time communication, high-speed data transfer, and determinism. So, So industrial internet offer the real-time communication, high speed data transfer, and data transfer and determinism. Determinism, as I said in previous lecture, it's about the, what is determinism? So determinism is about reduce the maintenance cost, okay? It can reduce the maintenance cost due to a lot of cable need to be used when in traditional Ethernet, and also it can enable faster cycle times, okay, and then also faster production rate, okay, faster production rates, and also ability to add more nodes and on a single bus. Depends on the environment in the industrial application. More nodes and on a single bus. If you use in industrial, if you use industrial Ethernet. Okay. Okay, and then next, for the conclusion with big, for the conclusion, with big data, you have the sensor collecting information and sending it back to PLCs, and even perhaps back to the desk of the person who's driving the entire system. So everything needs to be connected. As you are expect lah, and then so everything needs to be faster and farther by using industrial Ethernet today's. Okay, so it's up to you to choose which communication protocol is suitable to facilitate the transmission of data packet across the interconnected networks, either TCP/IP protocol, kan? If you want to use TCP/IP protocols or Ethernet IP or Profinet or also Modbus TCP/IP. It depends on the industrial application. If industrial application suitable to use TCP/IP, so you can use the TCP/IP in the industrial application. If the industrial application, the industrial environment is suitable to use in the Ethernet or Profinet, you can use this this protocol in the industrial Ethernet. Okay. Okay, I think that's all for the chapter 8. So, just a brief explanation about industrial Ethernet and wireless Ethernet. So, for the next session, we are going to discuss about WSN. So, what is WSN? Wireless sensor network. So, I think that's all for today. Thank you. So we dismiss our class. Thank you. Assalamualaikum.